on my melody. Diamonds are forever like my infinite thought. Like respect in the hood, they can't be bought. Word up, diamonds.
Diamonds. Diamonds. Diamonds. Yeah. Pick up the pen, write down the sins, cleanse. Lay this shit down, play it for friends, make a few M's, then do it again. J. Cole, who'd have thought you would have been? Rhyming with ghosts. Guru flows forever like a diamond at most. Could never afford the precious shoes, that's precisely why I'm blessing you. With clear cut messages, I'm destined to invest in urban sections where depression rules. I hope to heal the destitute before I leave this vestibule. Between the heavens and the seven circles where some dead homies maybe rest, I plan to resurrect a few. I press the truth against the neck of devils. Look at the youth just like a precious pebble, meant to be protected. Mentally, we let this poison of Western philosophy make us sloppy. We forgot we are the chosen. From hip hop to astronomy, they copy what we showed them. Niggas be talking slick, but only try me over modems. In person, they starstruck, they hearts flutter. I'm like the realest one you ever met. If you don't feel this one, give it a sec. Go live a little, let the years pass. Experience pain, watch the tears crash. Shown to the floor, hurt brings wisdom. Wisdom brings a whole nother sort of understanding. Diamonds only worth what we demand it. And niggas paying top dollar. Once upon a time, I paid 100 for mine. Now I'm a lot smarter.
Diamonds are forever like family and loyalty. Or real rap songs like Cream on my melody. Diamonds are forever like my infinite thought. Like respect in the hood that can't be bought. Diamonds are forever like family and loyalty. Or real rap songs like Cream on my melody. Diamonds are forever like my infinite thought. Like respect in the hood that can't be bought.
I rock diamonds that cut glass out of window panes. Ball head slick blazing tracks. When the endos flame, rocks that bling, rocks that make them jock my team, rocks that shine, rocks that keep my hand on my nine, rocks that blind, make the hard rocks drop dime, one of a kind, niggas best jet from the spot when I cock mine. Diamonds are like your man, you always call fam. Diamonds are like your grandma, you always call ma'am. Diamonds are like having the whole world in your hand. Diamonds are like the shows I rip with no band, rocking your knot, stopping your plot. It's me, ballhead slick Duke, copping your block. For you it's only pain, for me it's only gain. Diamonds are like loyalty, iced out like royalty. Diamonds are like my wifey, so sweet the way she spoils me.
Diamonds are forever like family and loyalty. Or real rap songs like Cream on my melody. Diamonds are forever like my infinite thought. Like respect in the hood that can't be bought. Diamonds are forever like family and loyalty. Or real rap songs like Cream on my melody. Diamonds are forever like my infinite thought. Like respect in the hood that can't be bought. Word up, diamonds, diamonds.
He was a young man in his prime, 25, but had already bagged a dime. They were serious together 5 years, but he was still curious about the life of his peers. See, they were all single, he was locked down. Liked to mingle, but loved his girl and child. Forgot to mention his son, 3 years of age. At times he felt trapped, but mostly enjoyed his cage. Of course he rapped, so he lived life on the stage. Town to town, going weeks without getting laid. Even though at every show, you know it's that one. Trying to kick it in your room and have some fun. Body banging like a bass line, you know the type. Knows your songs and checking your plans for the night. It's 3 a.m., so he knows the deal. For real, temptation's ill, but he knows he needs to chill. Look, but don't touch. Woman with a plan, 22 but had already found a man. He 25, kinda met him playing with his band. After his set, stepped off stage and took a hand. Just wanted to talk, wasn't trying to get in her pants. The beautiful conversation was a slow dance. 5 years later, she moves in. He's on the road more than she would like, but you know that's how he gets his dough. Home alone days, weeks, even months at a time. She tries to stay busy, but trouble races through her mind. Unsure of what he's doing while the sun rises. His voice on the phone and hear the dryer raining eyes. The girl was fine, so she always met guys. They sit and talk, and every now and then one tries. But her and her man, they built that trust. It may be hard, but she knows to look, but don't touch. Yeah.
What's up, Archie Dirk? You've been the microphone, Masters Radio.
Different, the pro in the business. Flow relentless, knocking them senseless. Talking consensus, we making hits, they hopping the fences. Pockets defenseless, money keeps on burning them holes. One swerving the road, and granny say that permanent's owed. Told my granny, sorry, but conservative's old. My alternative, though, I learned to turn these words into gold. By murdering flows, killer, I'm a businessman with a business plan, filling orders to fit demand. On a hush, not a crutch, well equipped to stand. Hot damn, give me your hand, give me your fan. White shadow, known to have rose or have risen. To those who have listened and those who have missed him, with no intermission, the flow getting christened. It shall be done, so it was written.
I was always told that I ain't gonna be part of the greatest.
Everybody that watches me fight, or everybody that has witnessed one of my bouts, they say that I am the greatest that they've ever seen.
We don't approach things like we're good. We just approach things like we're gonna work, and we're gonna work hard. Hard work pays off. If you work that hard, it's gonna be good, and good turns to great, and
see when the party gets to jump and call the flow 130. But when you up and catching worms, you know the flow come early. Like, funny how these people act like no one heard me, right? But shit, I'm making hits like it's the home run derby. Yikes, the long shot, went and got my city on lock. Risen from the rubble and up standing on top. Dusty South ENT, get it nonstop. The tonic, the flow, atomic, go and let the bomb cool. Onslaught, proportions are epic, the course could get hectic. Of course you expected, more like forced to accept it. I'm still young, but yet I'm so much more than just restless. These money rappers coming with that shit that's stored in the septic. Call it stress, a little something over a dose. White shadow, a little something more than a ghost. Riddle me this, what could be more than the most? Check your pulse, a moment to toast. So what was the fucking
greatest? I was
already
told that I ain't gonna be part of the greatest.
Everybody that watches me fight, or everybody that has witnessed one of my bouts, they say that I am the greatest that they've ever seen.
We don't approach things like we're good. We just approach things like we're gonna work, and we're gonna work hard. Hard work pays off. If you work that hard, you're gonna get good, and good turns to great, and hopefully I'm the definition.
Riding the flow, I'm the skipper, cat holding my swisher, so fly. These ladies only know with my zipper, scolding vinyls, leaving blisters. I spit fire on tracks, I'm not much more than a whisper, but my desire's my neck. I make hits, they go back, 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 and way gone. Stack the steak on top while they sit and scribble in crayon. Fit to take on anyone, a cocky amateur. No need for managers, I'll damage all your manicures. Shadow the janitor, keep it clean, but got some screws loose. New dude, sticking it to you like he practiced voodoo. Leader of the new school, you know I bust a rhyme. Just in time for the radio, AZ's on Justified. Under my rule, they must abide to feel the consequences. Cruel spitting shit so fat as feeling conscientious. Not to mention, at 18 with my rights reserved. Going down too deep for mainstream, get your life preserved.
For the prestige, not for me, but to uplift my little brothers who are sleeping on concrete floors today in America. People who are living on welfare. People who can't eat. People who don't know no knowledge of themselves. People who don't have no future.
Microphone Master Jay Love here with a gentleman. I listened to a little bit of his music and I'm looking forward to chopping it up with him. Gentleman by the name of Illogic. What's good, man?
What's up, man? Thanks for having me. I really appreciate it.
Nah, man, it's all good. I'm happy to chop it up with you. One of the things that, the first thing that came to me when I was listening to your music is, how do you as an artist with talent? So one of the first things that stuck out to me is that you are talented. Love the project, love what I heard. How do you as an artist that is talented stick out amongst a sea of MCs, good, bad, or indifferent, to really try to get yourself some momentum for whatever your goals are? How do you do that, man? How do you make that mark? How do you separate yourself from the rest?
I mean, honestly, what it boils down to is just being who you are and being comfortable in who you are and being able to articulate your own personal story. I think a lot of artists, you know, the artists that really connect with people are the artists that are secure in what their story is, what the story of their life is, and are able to convey that through their music. I think that's one of the things that, you know, over the years has drawn people to me, is that, you know, I've never been afraid to be vulnerable about who I am. I've never been afraid to be truthful about who I am, and how I feel about certain things, you know, whether it may be uncomfortable for certain people. You know, songs like a song I wrote, Hate in the Puddle, a long time ago, that was on my first album, was, you know, about my dealing with depression and how at times I hated myself and, you know, certain things like that. And there had, you know, being vulnerable in hip-hop has always been kind of taboo until, you know, maybe until the underground really started dipping into that, because we weren't afraid to tell stories and we weren't afraid to actually be who we were, and we weren't trying to, you know, be somebody we're not. So I think that's really what can make anybody stand out. I mean, with there being a sea of music everywhere, you know, it is more and more difficult to stand out amongst a sea of MCs and, you know, music. But I think the thing that people have to always be cognizant of is making sure that you tell your story and you tell your truth, and, you know, the people that are meant to hear it will hear it.
Here with Illogic, you can follow him on Twitter and all his social media at Illogic614. Here's something that interests me. You mentioned in terms of being your truth and really being able, really just being you to stand out. The new project is A Change in Mantra. And so the thing that I like is that it's short. I think that artists nowadays, when you have these 20, 25 song projects, and I see the reason for it when it comes to streaming, to give people a reason to stream and whatnot. But do you find that with a project like this, where it's only, as I say that in the air quotes, only 8 songs, that people are saying, all right, that's cool, what you got next? That you don't have an opportunity to really let your music breathe and really just stretch out and really be able to touch as many people as possible. Do you find that, or am I just overanalyzing that with my MC brain?
No, I think you have a point. I think what it is really with shorter projects, especially in today's climate, is, you know, there is so much information out there. I mean, basically, you know, people are as relevant as their Twitter feed, as being in somebody's Twitter feed, you know, like, people scroll through Twitter, scroll through Facebook, Instagram, all of that. And, you know, people's attention spans are much, much shorter these days. So I believe shorter albums, shorter projects probably can hit a little harder. And also it gives you a time to be concise in your vision. When you have, you know, extended projects that are, you know, 16, 20 tracks, you know, it's a lot of room for filler. When you have 8 songs, 5 songs, even, you know, I've seen 3 song EPs, you know, you hit them with the most powerful stuff as possible. You know, as an artist, you want to make sure that everything that you put out hits home. And when you have shorter projects, it gives you more of an opportunity to be concise in what you're trying to, you know, get across. So I think shorter projects are definitely the way for the future. I mean, that's why, you know, Kanye put out his last album was only, what, 7 songs. And doing and starting to do more things like that on a regular basis, you know, is honestly a throwback to when people were pressing up records anyway. Because if you think about it, like, Thriller was, what, 8 songs? And it was a full album. You go back to a lot of the older music, in order to press something on a record, it couldn't be longer than 35 minutes anyway. So most of the time, a lot of albums back then were, as far as song count, were shorter. So I think we're getting back into that, but also with attention spans being shorter, shorter projects are definitely the way to go.
I know a lot of people that rap that are artists in general, and as artists, we sacrifice a lot for our love of art. You know, especially when we have families, our families sacrifice a lot for us to, you know, be your entertainment and be your escape. And sometimes we're our own escape as well. But a lot of times you don't get to peek behind the curtain and see all of the things that your favorite artist had to go through. So I just want to give you a little peek of, you know, some of that from some experiences of my own and of others that I know. But this is just a little something for you. Check it out. He got 5 records out that you can purchase in the stores. 3 more in the works cause his mind's a machine. But sometimes he feels like, what's it all for? Even though he feeds off of hearing the crowd scream, but can barely pay his rent and barely keep his lights on. And his vehicle, it's on its very last leg. And the hole from borrowing from friends and family. Mount Everest ain't got nothing on his mountain of debt. He's gone hungry at times with multiple mouths to feed. A son, a daughter, a wife, and a child on the way. Doing everything he can
man to get everything they need. He'll be out on tour the day of his son's birthday in San Fran on his oldest third born. But it's his job, so what's there to do? He's an absentee father, part-time husband, half-ass provider, cause he gets paid to perform for you. We only write from experience, our lives are open books, so come on.